各位家人们，大家好。
Peace to be with you, all my family member.
我想最近，特别是上个礼拜，大家的心情都是非常非常的紧张，对不对
？So I believe you have a very anxious week, last week.
那当然在上一个星期四呢，就尘埃落定了。
So the what they call the decision was made on the last Thursday.
那你没有想到为什么大家的心情会受影响呢
？Have you ever pondered why you were so anxious?
为什么
？Why?
什么因素造成
？What are the reasons?
是谁做首相？那个做首相，当然那个是其中的因素。
Who become the prime minister is part of the reason.
我要问的是。背后有什么力量造成我们心中那么的七上八下
？So, I would like to know the reason, the real reason behind why it make you so anxious.
The power stimulating us 那是什么？ Yeah. 就是网络。
That is because of the internet.
赞成吗？为什么是网络
？Why is it internet?
因为资讯啊，刚才我们的主席一直谈资讯，就是资讯传得太快了。
So the spreading of the internet was too fast.
可以说呢是铺天盖地啊，来这个转播来传达。
So it's all cover all the areas in our country.
我们中国人很厉害啊，铺天的天都盖起来啊。
Oh, the Chinese world is saying that it's cover the whole sky.
你可以看到了啊，我们都受着网络影响的。
Really influenced a lot by the internet.
弟兄姐妹，让我们。一起的来关注网络。
So, brother and sister, let us pay attention together on this internet of things.
你不管网络管理。
If you do not manage this internet, then the internet will manage you.
我知道今天还是有一些人不是太喜欢网络的。
So I believe some of you do not like internet.
对一些电子这些的这个东西呢，没有太大兴趣的。
You're not interested in all those electronic things.
你知道早期啊，我跟师母是同样用两个人用一个 handphone 的哈。
So I shared together with 师母 previously on one handphone only.
杀都杀价，多二郎棍啊！
一只啫。
啊，只。
两个人 share。
你们当中有没有夫妻同样用一个 handphone 的？有没有？
So, do you share between the husband and wife?
你不可思议，对不对？你不会不可思议的。
So it's out of your imagination.
因为师母对电子的东西没有兴趣的。
Because my wife were not interested in all these electronic things.
所以我们的一个妥协就是一个电话两个人用。
So our compromise was that we share only one phone.
那结果是什么呢
？So what is the result?
通常来电都是他的电。
So all the incoming calls were picked up by her.
因为她是做辅导嘛，对吗
？Because she was she's the counselor.
所以过了一段时间，我说这个不行啊，拜托啊。
So after a while, I say this is not okay. So
最后勉为其难，她只好再买多一个手机。
So very reluctant, she bought another new handphone.
但是她还不是很喜欢手机的。
She still do not like the handphone.
所以整天就骂手机。
So always scolded at the handphone.
你不要买一个新的手机给她，那个手机一定咒骂的。
So do not buy a new handphone for her because she always gonna scold her.
她越骂手机，手机就越不跟她合作。
The more she scold her, phone is not working.
哎，这个很奇怪的，你好好想一下，真的，你不喜欢那样东西，那个东西就偏偏跟你唱反调的，你有没有注意到
？So do you know that if you do not really like the things, so you always against you.
到今天他还是哎呀，这个什么死手机啊，这样子的、啊，怎么怎么所以你看，这个没有办法啊。网络，你不喜欢它，它还是要管你的。
So you have proven that if the internet is you're not do not like internet, then the internet will come and rule over you.
你今天在外面吃东西
，when you eating out
用餐。
You're eating your meal?
你越来越发觉到很多商店很多餐馆已经是 cashless 无限款支付
So you see that many shops are cashless payment
你有没有注意到当然还是可以有你现在要到中国去了它几乎是没有用现款支付的
So it's almost every shops in China do not use cash payment anymore
微信 pop 解决了
微信 just to pay through 微信。
Well, 这个是一个趋势嘛，对吗？
So this is a trend.
在马来西亚是迟早的问题啊。
So to Malaysia, you'll come to that day.
还有你去用餐的时候。
So when you're having your meal,
你有没有发觉到现在越来越多的餐馆是 scan to order?
So there are many restaurants using the scan to order.
扫码下单，我们讲的扫码啊，扫一下就下单。
You have to place order through scanning.
前一阵子我跟师母到温州去一间餐馆来用餐。
So recently I went together with 师母 to a restaurant in 温州。
Okay, 然后呢就坐下来啊，那个侍应啊就过来了。
So we sat down and then the waitress came over.
他就放一张那个二维码放在我们桌上。
So she just put a QR code on the table.
师母啊，他也是对网络没有兴趣，对不对？还是没有兴趣啊？所以他说，哎 ，Where's the menu 啊？
So Mr. So still not interested in this QR code. And where's the menu? She said, "Yes."
No menu.
Scan to order. 没有这个菜单了。So 你要 scan.
我觉得是他说师母是有点不高兴啊。
So she was a little bit unhappy, I believe.
I want to order. Skip me the menu.
我现在要下订单，给我那个菜单。
那个司仪，我觉得他也是蛮怎么讲的，还不错了。他说 OK， give me a time， give me some time， 他就去那边找。
所以，
因为美诺很久没有用，也不知道放去哪里。
So because of long time never use, so eventually the waitress was looking around for the menu. Eventually,
结果他就还是找了一本出来了啊，我不晓得放多久了啊。
She managed to find one. Then,
很多陈了，因为很久没有人用了，对不对啊？这个他就哎，然后呢，你有 menu， 你还要写，对不对
？So she blew away all the dust on the menu, and then she need to write.
但是又没有那个 form， 那个没有了。
Oh, there are no more forms to write.
所以他最后想一个办法，就拿一张白纸，就帮你写在白纸上面。
So eventually, she just wrote on a piece of white paper.
他还不错啦，我觉得他因为他还是 customer first 啊，他就帮我们解决这个问题。
So the waitress was quite good. She managed to solve the problem for us.
最后，他跟我们讲一句话。
So eventually, she told us one thing.
我是蛮欣赏他讲这句话。
I really appreciate her attitude.
我不晓得师母的感觉怎么样，我看她脸色好像不是太高兴。
Look at her face. She wasn't so happy.
你知道他这个侍应啊，这个 waitress 跟我们讲什么话吗
？So what did the waitress say to us？
他说 ：“Boss, please learn a scan to code。”
哎，老板，拜托拜托啦，求你学一下，不要用这个二维码。
他就刺激我一下哦。
So he stimulated me for a while。
我就学 scan to code now， 因为他刺激我。
Oh, because of that, she stimulated me. So now I want to learn about this scan to order.
他做决定，因为如果再不 scan to code， 以后就没有东西吃了。跟他讲。
So if you don't do that, eventually you will have no food to eat.
因为这个是一个趋势来的。
So this is a trend.
你不管网络，你不喜欢网络，网络还是要管着你啊。
So even though you don't bother about the internet, but eventually the internet will manage you.
同意吗，弟兄姐妹？同意吗
？Do you agree?
啊，你看现在，银行最怕的是什么？
So what did what does a banker worry the most?
The bank. Yeah. Fraud, 那一些 scam, 网络欺诈，对吗？
The fraud and scam through internet.
你也怕，我也怕。
You also scared.
忽然间不见了一个零的在你的这个存款里面。
So if you have lost a one zero behind your savings.
你再不注意网络的发展呢，你可能真的是那个受害者啊，弟兄姐妹。
If you will become the victim if you do notYou do not catch up.
至少你会小心透过网络啊 ，online transaction， 你会很小心。
So, but you will pay you will be very careful when you perform the online transaction.
我们可以逃避吗，弟兄姐妹
？Can you avoid that?
是的，你现在还是可以。不过，再过一段时间，一年、两年、三年，你可以逃避吗
？Maybe you can escape now, but how about 2 or 3 years later?
那今天呢，我们谢谢我们的恩慈主席啊，刚才给我们做了很好的报告。
Want to give thanks to our brother Ernest for giving a very good report.
就是今天我们呼吁大家啊，关注我们的媒体施工，资讯媒体施工。
So today I want to urge you to pay more attention into our IMM ministry.
那这个是蛮有前瞻性的一份施工来的。
This is a very
foresight ministry. 会看到前面要发展的一门施工。
So you were able to see the future development ministry.
因为就是网络时代嘛，对吗，弟兄姐妹
？So we are living in the era of internet.
如果教会再不跟上这一般的列车，网络就是一般的列车，我们就落后了。
But if you do not catch up this train, then you will be left behind.
正好像刚才我所讲的，如果我们个人呢、啊、不跟上它，我们也会落后啊，对吗
？So for us individually, if we do not catch up, then we will be left behind.
所以就是要学，不断的学，学习跟上这个网络这一班列车。
Therefore, you have to learn continuously so that you will be able to catch up this train.
我告诉你，如果今天你不学，可能明天有新的东西，你一直没有办法跟上的。
So if you don't learn today, then tomorrow come new things, then you are not able to catch up.
所以它是一般网络是什么？一般列车，而且是不受约束的列车。
This is a unrestricted train.
Uncontrollable, 不受控制的列车。
This is an uncontrollable train.
现在谁可以控制网络？没有。
Who can control the internet nowadays?
没有。
Nobody.
它就是这样子哈，在现代的世界里头。能够在支配着我们每一个层面的生活，你同意吗
？He controls all areas of our life.
同意吗，弟兄姐妹
？Do you believe?
同意吗？支配着，听总牧师讲的话，是支配着啊 ，manage your life， 就是支配着你的生活，我的生活。
He's controlling and managing your life.
我看当中也有一些人在用手机啊，是不是？你看你崇拜你还用手机，他是不是支配着你的生活？
So you see, you during worship, you also using your handphone. So is it controlling your life?
我告诉你，我站在这里看得很清楚的。
So I can see very clearly over here.
啊 ，OK， 没问题，你继续玩，没问题，没问题。
Reading Bible.
这是他讲的。我给他一个掌声，他给你们一个鼓励的啊。哎，那个是啊，真的啊，你就可以用在手机里面读圣经嘛，对吗
？So you can read Bibles through phone.
支配着你和我的生活。
It's really controlling and managing your lives.
所以我要呼吁的是什么
？So what I would like to urge you is，
就是刚才我们的主席所讲的
，just like what our leader just said，
参与美加堂的资讯媒体施工 ，Amen。
So join the IMM ministry.
3M 的资讯媒体的，还有啊整个教会的网络的这个施工。
So all the ministry in our IMM.
有没有感动
？So are you moved？
啊，巴不得我们能够真的很认真的思考这个问题。
I really hope you can ponder upon this issue。
啊，今天啊，我们还是讲网络嘛，是吗
？So we are still talking about internet。
所以我的讲题是网络是神的恩赐。
So I say the theme of today is the internet is a gift from God。
啊，网络是神的恩赐。
Internet is a gift from God。
哎，这句话不是我讲的哈。
This is not said by me。
这句话是由一位全球啊最有影响的人影响力的一位基督教的领袖所讲的。
This is quoted by a global, well-known evangelist.
Not quoted. This is spoken.
Spoken. Quoted,
by the
spoken.
最有影响力的一位宗教基督教领袖所讲的。
The most influential Christian leaders said that.
是谁呢
？Who is he?
是谁？来，我们看一下啊，推演把它放出来，就是我们的教宗方济各。
It's our Pope Francis.
他讲这句话。
He said that
网络是上好的，然后他说是神的恩赐。
Internet is something truly good, a gift from God.
上帝的恩赐。
A gift from God.
有一位这么有影响力的一位基督教的领袖讲的这句话，你可以看到网络是何等的重要。
You can see the importance of internet because it's being said by very most influential Christian leaders in the world.
它是最好的，上好的。
It's something truly good.
因为它是神的恩赐。
Because it's a gift from God.
那大家如果有兴趣去看啊或者读教宗的。这一篇文章你可以在 Google 里面找到，就是啊，你把它 key in， 就是啊 ，Internet is a gift from God， 那这个文章就出来了，你可以去看的。
So if you're interested in this article, you just Google and then you type internet is a gift from God, then you will appear.
Now, 教宗方济各他提到三方面。
So Pope Francis has quoted three areas.
为什么他是神的恩赐啊？
Why is it a gift from God?
Gift 嘛 ，gift 是好东西来的，对不对
？Gift is something good, right?
圣诞节快来了，我们都准备买 gift 是吗
？So Christmas day is approaching, so we are preparing gift.
Gift 大家都很喜欢的。
So everybody like gift.
而来自上帝的 gift 恩赐，我们更喜欢，对吗
？But a gift from God, you even like it more.
为什么它是一个 gift 呢？
Why is it a gift?
为什么它是一个恩赐，一份神给我们的礼物呢
？Why we say that it's a present from God?
教宗他提到三方面。
So Pope Francis quoted three areas.
你好好听一下。第一，他说因为网络带来交流 ，communication.
Because the internet bring forth the communication.
交流大家交通嘛
Communication.
是吗？你看现在网络带来。这个交流的那一种的方便啊
，so you bring conveniences in communicating with each other。
这个我不详细讲了，大家都知道。然后他说网络带来联系啊 ，connection 联系。
So internet bring forth the connection。
所以今天你看到不管多远的这个地方，你的家人、你的亲戚什么，你可以联系他，是吗
？So today, irrespective of the long distance, we still manage to contact our family members.
过去是不可能的事情来的。
So previously was impossible.
现在是可能的不得了，联系。
So now it's really possible to communicate.
然后他说第三，这个网络它是带来团结的，团结。
So the third thing is the internet will bring forth solidarity.
团结
，solidarity.
透过网络，全世界的人，不同文化、不同宗教啊，不同什么、不同什么，能够有一些交流的机会。
So through internet, the people from different culture, different country, different race are able to communicate.
这个是以前不可能发生的事情。
So this will not happen previously.
这个团结的大前提就是大家可以理解对方嘛，了解对方。
So this solidarity.Team is so that you can understand each other.
所以这个前提就是你要团结，你先要彼此理解、了解对方。
In order to work together, then you have to understand each other.
所以透过网络，你可以看到我们至少可以彼此了解。
So through internet, we are able to understand each other.
比如说我们讲基督教跟回教。
So for instance, we say about Christianity and Islam.
看过去啊，这个。宗教之间有许多的误会啊
，so there were so many understanding between misunderstanding between Christian and Muslim and Islam.
因为这个沟通联系啊没有那么方便
，because there were inconveniences in communicating.
这个资讯方面呢、有许许多多的中断
，so there were many breaking up on this communication.
而是因为有网络。
But because of internet,
我们可以沟通
we are able to communicate,
我们可以理解
so we are able to understand,
以致逐渐团结
so gradually we are able to unite together.
当然背后还有许许多多的这些层面我们可以去理解的
Of course, there are many other areas that we are able to understand.
就几个大方向帮助大家嘛，是吗
？So there are at least a few big directions that we are able to understand.
交流
，so communicating，
联系
，connection，
然后团结
，and to unite together.
那这是教宗的这个讲座里面的重点。
So this is the main point brought through by Pope Francis.
所以弟兄姐妹。网络是神的恩赐。
Therefore, brother and sister, internet is a gift from God.
好，我们再看另外一个很重要的一种的这个认知啊。
So now we have to bring another area of conscience to you.
第二点啊，网络可以使基督徒可以发声。
So internet give Christians a voice.
现在我们都。怎么讲呢？可以表达自己的信仰，对吗，弟兄姐妹
So brother and sister, we are able to express our faith, right?
过去是可以，但是许多的障碍。
Previously, there were so many obstacles we want to express our faith.
但是透过网络，我们可以发声。
But now through internet, we are able to voice out.
我们可以表达我们的信仰。
We can express our faith.
发声很重要。
So to voice out is very important.
那这里我要再提醒大家另外一件事情。
I would like to remind you another thing.
如果你不发声，
if you are not voicing out,
所谓的 voicing 就表达你的信仰的意思哈。
Meaning to say they are expressing your faith.
如果你不发声，
if you are not voicing out,
撒旦就用网络来发声。
So Satan will use the internet to voice out.
你同意吗？
Do you agree?
今天，比如说有一些的这个啊，所谓的邪教啊，跟一些的巫术啊。这个 couch and witchcraft， 他们大量用网络来传播他们的思想。
The witchcraft and the craft， they will always use internet to share their religion。
我想年轻人都很熟悉的一个平台叫做 TikTok， 对不对？抖音。
Oh， so I believe the youngster are very well was on this TikTok。TikTok。
我们的主席也刚才有报告，有注意，有注意到的报告嘛？谈到这个 TikTok， 这个是一个很棒的平台来的，很棒的 apps 来的。
It's a really wonderful apps。
啊，但是我发觉到呢，啊，在我很表面的认知当中，啊，表面的认知当中呢，我发觉到那一些很所谓的我们的。这个一般的这个流量啊，你知道那种 viewer 和流量啊，哎，用 TikTok 的这些人啊，基本上啊，他们不是我们的教会的人哦。
So on the surface, I see all those those person who use the TikTok are not from
Christian circle.
From Christian,
包括我们的油管 YouTube.
Oh, including our YouTube.
不是给油的那条管
YouTube
嘛，对吧？对吧？油管就 YouTube 嘛，对吧？就 YouTube 就油管了，对不对？抖音就是 TikTok 嘛，对吗？啊，对吧？啊，抖音就 TikTok 吗？
啊，是是。
我有说，
油管没有听过啊，是。应该是你的管吧 ？YouTube 啊 ，YouTube。
那这个是中国翻译的啊，这个 YouTube 是油管。
Translated by China, so it's a.
基督徒的流量，不管是 viewer 或者是制作媒体的基督徒，我觉得不多，真的不多。
So those content creator from Christians are not many.
那我说我是初步啊表很表面的一个觉察到的。
This is just my very surface observation.
反而我看到一些的报告啊。
But I saw some reports.
那一些邪教，那一些的所谓的。无数啊，记得哈，啊，他们的用这个 TikTok 或者 YouTube 的，他们的数量远远超过基督徒。
Those is it heresy or
cult and
cult.
Witchcraft?
Cult and witchcraft. They're using a lot of internet.
而且吸引大量的这个所谓的这个观众，所谓的 viewer.
So we have attracted a lot of viewers.
同意吗，弟兄姐妹？特别是年轻的一代。
Do you agree? Especially the younger generation.
他们很向往这一些的视频。
So they are really looking forward for all these videos.
所以我说，我们教会基督教基督徒，你和我不用这些网络，撒旦用。
So Christians, if you do not use all this internet, then the Satan will use it.
同意吗，弟兄姐妹
？Do you agree?
同意吗
？Do you agree?
我觉得了哈，也是我觉得哈。今天我们必须要发声 ，give a voice.
Oh, today we must voice out, brothers and sisters.
怎么样发声
？So how to voice out?
我们也要学习制作这个自媒体 iMedia.
So we have to produce all these iMedia.
iMedia 就自己做媒体。
So we have to produce media.
就是因为有这一些的。应用程式 apps 的方便，就好像 TikTok， 比如说，你就可以制作媒体了。
So because of the conveniences of all these apps, so we are able to produce more iMedia.
像美加堂，我们讲美加堂。
Just like our church.
我们目前有至少有三个自媒体。
So at least we have three iMedia.
这个美加甘泉。
Mega Stream.
Mega Devotion.
Devotion.
第二就是Coffee Break.
Second one is the Coffee Break.
第三就是 MEC 的我们 Pastor Matthew 做的这个 Chick Chat 聊天室。聊天室。
So the third one is the one produced by Reverend Matthew.
我希望以后会更多恩慈主席
I hope there will be more, brother.
不管是你个人的，或者是教会方面的，我们都要发声，分享信仰。
So whether it's from yourself or from the church, so we have to voice out.
那我提醒弟兄姐妹
，I want to remind you.
你可能会觉得，哎呀，这个不好看的，这些不好看，闷死掉。
Maybe you will say, oh, so boring.
弟兄姐妹，我拜托了，你是基督徒，你不支持基督徒的媒体，你我们基督徒的媒体怎么可以发展呢？
Brother and sister, if you do not support the Christian media, so how could we develop as a Christian media?
你满意不满意那是另外的问题。
Whether you are satisfied or not satisfied is another matter.
你看，你 coffee break， 哎呀，几十个流量，没料的，没看，不要看。
So when you look at the coffee break, only tens over viewers.
没有人 like 的，没有人 like 的。
And nobody like it. I don't want to watch.
我不是说你要 like 我，没有。
It doesn't mean that I ask you to like me.
我只是提醒大家。
I just want to remind you，
这是你的参与的一个很关键的一件事情啊。
So this is the how you have to participate. It's a very crucial.
我刚才讲了，你满意这些视频或者不满意我们基督教做的视频，那是另外的问题。
So whether you are satisfied with it or not is another matter.
你可以给意见我们，让我们改善，对不对
？So we can give suggestion to us so that we are able to improve.
但是你记得牧师要讲的话。
So, but you have to believe. You have to listen to what the pastor say.
你要关注，你要支持啊，弟兄姐妹。
You have to pay attention. You have to support.
那我们就做得更好啊。
So that we can do better.
你连自己的媒体，基督教圈子的媒体，你自己都不看啊，你期待什么人看啊？你告诉我。
So you don't even want to watch your own church media. So who else want to watch?
你告诉我，谁看
？Tell me who want to watch.
你想那些非信徒会看吗？
Do you think the believer will watch?
所以你不单看，你要转发啊 ，share.
So not only watch, you have to share as well.
你就可以看到，透过这个网络的这个效能啊，效益啊，那基督徒可以发声。
So you were able to see the effect of voicing out. Then the Christian are able to voice out.
Voice out 什么？分享信仰嘛，对吗
？So is what is the voicing out to share your faith?
感谢主啊，有网络，真的感谢主。
Praise be to the Lord because of internet.
而问题是我们怎么样去使用它呢
？So, now is how are you going to use this media?
很多负面的这一些的价值观在网络里面传播。
There are so many negative
values, 价值观。
The values, negative values spread in the internet.
年轻人有没有注意到
？So our youngster, have you paid attention to that?
那我不要讲这个是大课题来的，但是我可以告诉你，这些的负面的价值观会一直的影响着我们。
So this is a very big issue because all these negative, what they call thoughts, will influence us.
那我就举一个例子哈。
I give you an illustration.
最近中国很流行叫做躺平，对不对？躺平。
So, lately the China is very popular with this lying down culture.
年轻人。
So youngster.
什么叫躺平
？So what do you mean by lying down?
如果大家有兴趣，可以看我有一期的 coffee break， 我是讲躺平的。
So if you are interested, you can watch my coffee break. One of the episodes.
我忘记第几期了，那个是好久以前的。我就讲，我就回应躺平这件事情。
So I was responded on this issue of laying down.
那当然，他有他的背景啊。
So of course, he have his background.
但是如果这样的东西你接触了，你是一个年轻人，你怎么样去看待躺平这件事情呢
？So as a youngster, if you watch over such a thing, such culture, so what is your response into it?
可能你会被他的那些负面的一些的信息会影响你的。
Maybe it will influence you. The negative impacts will be on you.
躺平，它几个重点就是今天我再不在这个社会里面做什么什么这个龙争虎斗啊，拼命工作那一种的心态的没有。
So lying down culture meaning that you are not striving for your lives anymore.
我经常地跟年轻人讲，啊，你要努力赚钱，什么什么什么。哎 ，sorry， 我再不跟你玩这种东西了。
So if you tell a youngster nowadays we have to strive for our futures, but if it's a lying down culture, they will don't bother about that.
所以你看，这种躺平背后就是那些年轻人说，哎，我一年工作大概两三个月就好了。
So such a laying down culture will make you to work only 2 or 3 months a year.
赚了一点点钱
，then you make some money，
够吃够用就好了。
Sufficient for you to eat and
to eat and stay. 你知道啊？对不起啊，啊，就对不起啊。如果当初有中国来的我们的同胞啊
，So if our brother and sister from China
啊，你如果要结婚了 啊，对面对方一定问有没有车啊你。
So if you want to get married, then the other party will ask you, "Do you have car?
有没有房子啊
？Do you have house?
有没有银子啊
？Do you have money?
这三样很重要吗
？Such three things are important.
房子、车子、银子啊。
So car, house, and money.
那如果你躺平，你怎么赚钱、赚房子呢？不可能的事情嘛，对吗
？So if you are lying down, so how can you make such things?
那意思说你再不争取什么呢？你放弃了
？If you are not fighting for all these things and just give up.
哎，我就舒舒服服过日子好了。
So I just live my life comfortably.
啊，做工作两三个月够了。
I just work 2 or 3 months. That's it.
有的住，有的吃就好了。
Enough to stay and eat, then that's it.
我为什么那么辛苦
？Why do I have to struggle so hard？
啊，这个很简单的一个躺平的一个背景哈。
So this is the background of lying down.
哎，弟兄姐妹，这一份的欣喜躺平呢，已经传播到全世界去了。
Brother and sister, this sort of messages has been sent across the world.
日本有这样的信息啊，接受被躺平的东西影响，韩国也有。
So Japanese and the Korean were affected by this.
他们是用不同的名称来表达同样的东西。
But they will use different terms to express this.
哎，马来西亚呢
？How about Malaysia?
我发觉到今天我们年轻人呢，我也有点担心啊，担心一点点啊，并不是很大担心。年轻人听好好听牧师讲什么。
I have a little bit worry for you, our youngster.
我担心什么呢
？What do I worry?
我发觉到啊，我们是有一点这样的症状啊 ，COVID-19.
We have such a symptom like COVID-19.
中国武汉病毒好像也影响到我们一点点啊，这个躺平的病毒，躺平病毒。
This laying down virus has affected us.
你们看到今天年轻人，马来西亚年轻人，我特别讲，哎，他可以不做工一年的。
You notice the youngster in Malaysia, some of them no need to work for 1 year.
佩服得不得了。
I really respect you.
大学毕业以后
，After graduation,
跟父母说
，and tell the parents,
I will take a leave.
我要拿假期哦。
喂，老兄、弟兄、姐妹
，my brother and sisters,
你还 take 什么 leave 啊？你都毕业了 ，take 什么 leave？
So you already graduated. Why are you taking leave?
我两个月去哪里玩玩，去哪里玩玩这样子。
So I will travel to this place 2 months, and then another few months this the other place.
哎，你觉得这个是不是有点走向躺平的那一个路了？
So are we directing towards this lying down culture?
啊，我是说有没有？我不是说你是，我是把这种的症状提出来给你听一下。
I'm just telling you about these symptoms.
你看今天我们的年轻人好厉害的，我们 OK 一份工作不做了，我们可以休息很久才做另外一份工作的哦。好厉害哦，我们。
The youngster are really wonderful. They can work for one job and then stop for a few months.
没有，你不同意也没关系，你不同意也要同意，因为真的有这样的状况出现在我们当中。
It's really happened amongst you, even though you disagree with.
而且父母也觉得，哎呀，没事啦，好好休息一下。哎，老兄。
But the parents say also okay, it's okay, just rest.
开什么玩笑啊你？
哎 ，Are you joking?
我过去40年做牧师吧，我没有说请假过一年的，这么厉害啊
！So I have been pastor for 40 years. I have never applied for leave for 1 year.
有老婆有女儿，什么你可以不必做啊？你钱从哪来啊？祷告天跌下来的钱啊
！You have wife and daughter to feed. So if you don't work, where does the money come from？
哎，其实今天年轻人躺平啊，父母要负责任哦。
So nowadays, if the youngster lying down, then their parents are responsible.
因为你太宠他们了。
Because you over-pampered them.
我告诉你，如果你让你的孩子不要躺平，把水喉关掉。
So if you don't want your children to like to have this lying down culture, just what they call close the water pipe.
啊，水喉啊，不是我的 tank
啊，不是，
好劲啊，我的 tank， 我死啊，全家都死晒，冇水饮。
水即自财嘛。 Water is money. Water is money. Stop their financial resources.
我的天，我开玩笑，太恐怖了。你今天父母就是啊，那你就太你的水壶开太大了，他们觉得没问题，没关系，爸爸妈妈大把水。
Because you over pamper them, you give them too much money. Because you say you're rich.
你觉得同意吗？你同意吗，弟兄姐妹
？So do you agree, brothers and sisters?
那为什么要讲这个呢
？So why am I sharing this?
Okay, 啊，长话短说。
So I want to make it in short.
一个很不正当的价值观，透过网络来传播。
So an improper value system has been spread over the internet.
而且你们我们的孩子都是首当其冲被影响的。
So our children are the persons who are in the forefront to be affected by it.
小心哦。
We have to be careful.
那我们怎么办
？So what shall we do?
教会可以做什么
？So what can the church do?
所以这些媒体的事工基本上就是传播正能量，对吗
？Amen. So the functions of the IMM is to share about the positive messages
values.
基
督教的正能量。
Positive power of a Christianity.
Positive value of Christianity. Value, 这个价值观很重要，价值观是我们影响我们思想的。
So this value system is very important because it's influencing us.
我举个例子，什么价值观？
So I'll give an example.
什么是基督徒的价值观？
So what is the value system of a Christian?
责任感。
So the sense of responsibility.
年轻人听好来，责任感很重要。
So youngster, the sense of responsibility is very important.
今天我非常非常的担心，我们的责任感越来越轻了，没有看重。
I'm seeing we are having a less and less sense of responsibilities nowadays.
年轻人
，youngsters，
讲了不算数的那一种。
They never uphold to what they say.
责任感。
So the sense of responsibility.
还有什么呢？
So,
礼貌
the politeness, the polite
manner,
polite manner,
礼貌
polite manner.
你有没有看到啊？我不要讲现在了。以前我在做主理牧师的时候，哎，有一些年轻人看到我啊，他没有教我的哦。
When I was a senior pastor in this church before, many youngsters saw me and they never address me. Greet me.
人形咁。
As if he's an invisible man.
Manners. 中国人特别在中国人，连中国人都那么看重 manners。我们基督徒的中国人难道不是要更看重礼貌嘛？对吗
？So the Chinese pay so high respect on this manner, but why are we Chinese Christians are not paying into it?
你们在家里面怎么对待父母的？你告诉我。
So how you treat your parents in your family? Youngsters, how?
我听到父母时常跟我说，他说我孩子没有礼貌。
So I always heard that the parents say that my children are very impolite.
那我不要讲你怎么没有礼貌，你自己知道。
So you will know by yourself.
还有什么东西呢
？So what else?
诚信 ，integrity， 诚信。
Integrity is another one.
诚信就是什么叫诚信啊
？So what do you mean by integrity？
你看圣经里面经常告诉我们。
So the Bible always tells us。
你好，去读圣经。圣经一个很棒的价值观呢、啊，就是诚信。
So the very good value in this Bible is integrity。
这是耶稣基督彰显出来的。
So this is the manifested through Jesus Christ。
耶稣基督坚持他的大使命，他死在十字架上。
So Jesus Christ insisted on the Great commandment, so he died on the cross.
我要学耶稣呢？你学耶稣什么东西啊？你告诉我。
So if you say I want to learn from Jesus, what are the things that you are supposed to learn from him?
太多东西了，太多东西了啊。
So there are too many things to learn.
但是我就提一样。
So I only want to address one.
诚信
，integrity.
诚实和信任。
The honest and to be trusted.
你是一个可以被信任的人吗？
Are you a person who can be trusted?
哇，这东西很多东西可以讲的，弟兄姐妹。
So there are many things to say on this.
可以透过网络来传播嘛，对吗
？And you can through iMedia to share on this.
而且它的影响力是很大的。
And the influence is very very great.
所以啊，我们可以发声啊，网络让基督徒发声。
So internet will let you voice out.
在这个过程当中，其实。 你可以为主做很多很多的工作。
So in this journey, we are able to do so many things for the Lord.
好，最后一点
The last point.
第三点，我们看看网络，它可以扩张教会在线上注意在线上的境界。
So internet can expand the church's territories online.
在线上不是在地上，在线上。
So it's online, it's not.
什么意思呢？
So what do you mean by that?
好啊，那我们再看，我们回去看那些圣经啊，弟兄姐妹来啊。马可福音十六章十五节。
Mark chapter 16 verse 15。
好不好啊？大家一起来念一下好不好？来，一二三，他又对他们说：“你们往普天下去，传福音给万民听。”他又对他们说：“你们往普天下去。”
And he told him to go
in,
and he told him to go into the world and preach the good news to everyone.
大家都很熟悉的，这是耶稣基督讲的大使命。
So it is the great commandments that you are very familiar.
传福音
and to share gospel.
还记得刚才我们所背的圣经吗？
So remember the scripture that we memorized just now.
分享福音
is to share the gospel.
怎么样做？
So how do you do it?
传统的做法就是你在我面前，我在你面前，大家讲。
So traditionally, like you are in front of me, then I share with you.
或者一个牧师在台上讲。
Or a pastor is preaching on the pulpit.
这是过去的方式。现在还可以用，没问题的，还可以用。
Maybe it was used previously and still used now.
你注意耶稣讲什么？你们往普天下去哦。
So what did Jesus say? You go into the world.
The all nation, 有一个翻译就是 all nation. 哇，这个很棒的。怎么样去？问题是。
So how to go into the whole world?
很简单
，very simple，
我们做到
，we can do it。
万民都在你的手机里
，so everyone is in your handphone。
万国都在你的手机里
，every nation is in your handphone。
大家看看你的手机，如果你在看 YouTube 的话，看看
，you see your handphone，
或者你看 TikTok 的，看看，哎。万民原来万国都在我的手机里啊！
Oh, eventually you discover that the whole nation is in your handphone.
可以咯，耶稣讲的可以做啦。
You can do it.
那有没有去人信耶稣是另外的问题。我不是说现在他们就可以信耶稣，没有。
Whether they will believe in Christ or not is another matter.
就像你今天我跟你传福音在面对面的，你也不一定信耶稣嘛，对吗
？So just for instance, if I share with you face to face, then you may not have a belief in Jesus Christ.
那个不是你的问题，你的问题就是你要做的就是传福音罢了。
So that's not your problem. Your responsibility is just to share the gospel.
他要不要信耶稣是神的工作 ？Amen.
Whether he want to believe in Jesus Christ is the work of God.
那你今天怎么样做？万民万国啊，坐在你手机里跟他们传福音。
So all countries and all nations is in the handphone. So how are you going to share?
那这些人要不要信耶稣是另外的问题。
So whether to believe or not is another matter.
你可以看到，透过网络你可以传达福音嘛，对吗？
So through internet, you can share the gospel.
所以今天有所谓的这个网络的 online missionary 网络宣教士。
So today you can heard about on this the online missionaries.
你不必派一个人哇，这个遥远的飞到什么什么国家去做宣教士，已经这个方式已经慢慢被淘汰了。
So you no need to send the missionaries to cross over the nations and to share gospel there. This one will be.
如果那个地方有网络的设备的，你就可以传福音。
If there are internet providers over there, so they are able to share the gospel there.
同意吗，弟兄姐妹
？So do you agree with it?
所以每个人都可以做宣教士。
So everybody can become the missionary.
就是网络宣教士 ，online missionary.
Which is the online missionary.
你可以就发一个推文，一个贴文在你的 Facebook 里面就可以让很多人看到了。
So you can just put a statement onto your internet, and then everybody can, a lot of people can see.
那在这个过程当中，你看到呢，就是福音传遍了全世界了。
So in this process, then you are able to see the gospel has been spread over the world.
我们讲讲我们讲讲手机。
So we are talking about handphone now.
今天蛮多弟兄姐妹都用手机来读圣经，对不对
？So many brothers and sisters are reading Bible through handphone.
对吗
？Yeah.
我们说电子版圣经 digital Bible.
You say about talking about the digital Bible.
Okay, 那过去没有 digital Bible 就是那个所谓的 hard copy Bible。
So previously we have this hard copy Bible。
哎，我告诉你一个点，一个很有意义的、很有意思的这个历史啊。
So I will tell share with you one history。
有关于圣经的。
Regarding Bible。
好好听啊，很重要的。
Yeah, pay attention, please。
十五世纪之前，十五世纪。
Before 15th century。
圣经都是基本上是手抄的。
Mostly all the Bibles were handwritten.
Copy.
A copy.
当时啊，就算是手抄也是蛮辛苦的。
So even though if it's a handwritten, it's a very tough.
没有纸张。
Because no paper.
没有什么这个抄写的工具。
So you don't have the tools to handwrite.
用什么牛皮或者是木头啊来雕刻啊来写，那是很麻烦，很麻烦。
So you had to craft on the skin, the cow skin or the wood.
那在这个过程当中，能够拿到一本圣经，做成一本圣经，那简直就是神迹来的。
So it's like a miracle in order to produce a Bible,
yeah,
a complete Bible.
可以说是千辛万苦才能够一本圣经出现。
It's really through endless efforts then you are able to produce one Bible.
但是在十五世纪的时候
，But on the 15th in the 15th century,
发明了这个印刷机啊。
So they invented this printer.
Printing press,
they call it printing press.
Printer is a very modern word. At the time, it was printing press.
Printing press.
The result, I tell you, the first printing press of the Bible was found in Germany.
So the first printed versions of Bible is in German.
从那个时候起，圣经就越来越普遍，越来越多人有机会读圣经了。
Since then, Bible has become more and more popular and even more readers.
啊，长话短说哈。
So to keep it short.
当代啊，我们说十五世纪。
15th century.
有这个 printing press， 圣经可以出版。
Because of printing press, the Bible can be published.
21世纪今天的时代
21st century, our current era.
因为有网络
Because of internet.
我们有更有效的传达圣经传播圣经就是什么我们的 digital Bible. Amen.
So through digital Bible, we can able to share the...
Through internet.
Through internet, we are able to share the gospel more efficiently.
The Bible.
The Bible.
所以有电子版圣经。
Because then you have this digital Bible.
跨时间、跨地区接触没有信耶稣的这些网民。
So it transports, transpass.
Across time.
Across time.Across territories and engaging netizens, non-believers.
网民就是 netizen 的意思啊 ，netizen 就
net，netizen
net 上的那一些 citizen， 这个是一个新的字来的 netizen 啊，这个不是我创的，这个是在网络里面的一个名称的，就是那一些 netizen 网民。
Netizen meaning to say that the citizen in the net.
Okay, right. 所以你和我都是 citizen in the net.
So we are the citizen in the net.
所以你看到这个网络就好像当代的印刷机一样啊，让圣经可以更全面的来传播。
So this internet like just a pressing machine previously just able to share the Bible on a widely basis.
很棒，非常棒。
It's really wonderful.
难以想象的事情。
It's beyond imagination.
但是问题还是。
But the problem is.
你会珍惜它吗？
Are you going to appreciate it?
你会用它吗？
Are you going to use it?
我们有没有关注这件事情呢
？So have you ever paid attention into this matter?
所以今天我们这个资讯媒体的这个主热啊。
So in this IMM day,
我们的目的是什么
？So what is our purpose?
唤起大家要关注网络。
So that will urge you to pay more attention into internet.
你说不是啊，我很关注网络啊。
And you say, no, I have paid attention to internet.
我再补充一句。
我 want to add one more statement.
关注网络 ，very good， 很好。
Yeah, you pay attention to internet. It's very good.
但是你关注网络，有没有用网络来表达我们的信仰呢
？But have you used the internet to express your faith?
to share your faith 啊，如果你没有这一个，那这个也不是我们的目的了。就是说啊，这个资讯媒体的主的也没有达到目的。
So if you didn't do that, then the IMM they will not give you any purpose.
所以我再重复，这个很重要。
So I want to repeat again.
我们每个人都关注网络。
So everybody pay attention into the internet.
我们的生活离不开网络。
So our life cannot live without internet.
但是我们要更上一层楼。
But we have to go one step further.
透过网络
through internet,
分享我们的信仰
to share our faith.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
怎么样分享？
So how you share?
前面我已经讲过了。
So I have shared with you just now.
制作你的自媒体，分享信仰。
So produce your own videos and to share your faith.
如果你觉得哎，不是这个太难了，没关系，
so、
把一些的圣经啊放在这一个。Facebook 里面
So you say too difficult, but I can encourage to put some Bible verses in your Facebook.
不要讲一大堆废话
Don't talk so much rubbish.
网络里面太多废话了
So many rubbish in
the 你自己看很多废话，对不对？有时候我看到都很好笑的，这个什么东西啊？
So really ridiculous.
你说不是这个有用吗？把圣经放上去有用吗？
So you say, Pastor, is it really useful if you put the Bible verses in the internet?
你不必担心，那个不关你的事。
So you don't have to worry.
It's
not your business. That is the business of God.
你的工作是什么？把它放上网络去。
So your work is to put into the internet.
跟你的朋友分享你的信仰，做见证。
To share your faith with your friends and your testimony.
或者转发一下 Coffee Break 或者美加甘泉这个东西。转发。
And to share on this Coffee Break.
我做，你帮我转发，好不好？行不行
？So I do, then you share
行不行
for me.
那更简单啊， okay. 你不必做，我做罢了。然后你就转发就好了。
So all you need to do is just to share.
反正你不单单转发，你要先看的，不要乱来啊！你先看了才转发、啊。
Of course, you have to view it first before you share.
我很短的，我的 coffee break 大概最多就十分钟左右罢了。
It's about 10 minutes of my coffee break.
浪费很多时间的。
So you will not.Waste your time.
你就转发嘛，对吗
？Just to share.
所以今天下午3:15记得。
So today, 3:15 p.m.
进入美加堂网站，然后看我的 coffee break.
So watch my coffee break.
啊，好不好？行不行
？OK.
啊，不表示我什么厉害，没有，我只是说大家，我就有出一份绵力嘛，对吗？绵力。
So I
have cotton power. Cotton power.
I have done some cotton power. I use a little bit of my cotton power.
好厉害啊 ，cotton power！ 你这绵力怎么翻呢、啊？英文哪一个英文比较好？
So who has a good command of
English? 在那里，美丽怎么翻？翻英文。
How to
cotton power 可以吗 ？Cotton power.
Cotton strength, I think.
Cotton strength. Cotton 哪里有 strength 的？
God.
那个是很 well, anyway, good. Cotton strength, what's okay? 那想，我一直想一个。
我就想。
明天告诉我。哎呦，我找来找去找不到这个这个美丽怎么翻呢 ？Anyway, 弟兄姐妹，你可以做很多东西啊 ，Amen。
Brother and sister, you can do a lot of things.
你看啊，美加堂有三方面的施工啊，都是在促进网络施工的。
So there are three areas of our church that will promote this internet ministry.
这个资讯媒体施工。
So we have this infocom media ministry.
就是刚才恩赐执事他报告的。
So what has been shared by our brother Ernest?
All right, 然后呢，我们有。网络媒体、网络教会施工。
So we have digital church ministry.
李祖国做没有领袖做这个领导的。
So our lay leader Brother Jacob is a leading.
然后还有很重要的就是美加这个多媒体施工。
So we have this mega multimedia ministry led by our LCC member Derek.
所以你看这个三个部门就彼此合作嘛，是吧
？So these three ministry worked with each other closely.
做什么
？So What do they do?
透过资讯媒体网络来传福音。
Through info media and internet to share the gospel.
如果你问我牧师，美加堂5年之后将会怎样
？So if you ask me, what will happen to Mega CMC after 5 years?
不要讲太远了，10年了什么？我们讲5年就好了。
We just talk about 5 years, not 10 years.
5年，我可以。告诉大家，如果真正可以做什么，我不敢讲。但是我可以先跟你讲，如果你现在美加堂不接轨，刚才我有提到接轨 connect 这个快速的列车 所谓的网络，我们的事工没有大事突破的。
So we are not able to break through if we do not do it within this 5 years of time, which is to connect with the train that we are mentioned, multimedia.
这个是肯定的，因为整个大趋势是这样子跑。
This will surely happen because the main trend is like that.
但是我们需要你的参与。
But I need your participation.
Amen. 需要你的参与。
Amen.
可能是奉献啊，让我们对吧？这个改善或者能够提升我们这些器材的功能嘛，对吗
？Maybe through your offering, you are able to upgrade our facilities.
Yeah. 然后你的能力的参与，能力。
So you can through your own effort to participate.
啊，你是某一方面的这个专才的，参与这个侍奉。
So if you are the expert in one of the areas, you may come and serve.
然后你还可以做更重要的是什么？
So there are more important things that you can do.
就是刚才我所讲的。
That is what I have shared just now.
做一个 online missionary.
To become an online missionary.
Amen.
Amen.
上帝祝福大家。
God bless everybody.
请赞美团到前面来。好。